Good morning. God bless you and welcome to our service of remembrance for a servant of Jesus Christ who has gone to be home with his Lord. Today we gather with the family and with friends and with people all over the world to remember and celebrate the life of King David Sumbe Ali, a king because of the love and the generosity in his heart and the way that he cared for his family. That is what we come to celebrate. But most of all, we come to celebrate the fact that when God called him, David went home. He went to the place that Jesus had prepared for him, the promise that he gave to all who believe in him. And I thank you so much for being here this day to honor the family. After the service, there'll be a processional to Evergreen Cemetery where we will conclude the service with a graveside service. So I wanted to be sure you were aware of that. They will process the funeral director is here to help you get in the line for that if you wish to go to that, to get in the car line for that. They will help arrange that. But you are also welcome to come to the graveside if you wish to do so. Again, we thank you for being here, and those of you watching online, we thank you for being here. Last night, over 350 people watched from around the world online, from Togo, from France, from Malawi, from many different places. And that shows you how important David was to so many people. So let's celebrate his life and give him to the Lord. Our call to worship is the 23rd Psalm. You will see on the screen all the stanzas for the songs we'll be singing tonight, and you will see the psalm. Everything we'll be sharing. So let's join together. You'll also find it in your bulletin. Let's join together and say the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we ask your Holy Spirit to be upon this loving family at this time, upon we who are a part of David's community of faith that are gathered here, friends, those who've known him, Lord, and those around the world who are joining us by your Holy Spirit in this hour. May you bless us, Lord, with your presence, your comfort. Help us, Lord, to share together a warm and loving memory of he who has gone before us. We ask, Lord, that you would receive his soul and that in doing so you would keep him in your peace. Lord, we are so grateful that as disciples and as believers in your name, we can gather, Lord, yes, to mourn, but also to celebrate a life well lived, a life of generosity, a life of caring. Not a perfect life, Lord, as none of us are, but Lord, a life whom you loved and who loved you. So this day, Lord, we remember David with great joy and affection. So be with us now. In your holy and gracious name, we make this prayer. Amen. Our opening hymn is number 630, Fairest Lord Jesus. You'll find it in your hymnal. You'll also see the stanzas on screen. And we ask that when the music begins, if you would stand if you wish to do so. Let us sing Fairest Lord Jesus.
Amen.
You may be seated. Thank you. For our Old Testament lesson this morning, the family has chosen Psalm 139, verses 1 through 12. It is a beautiful psalm of David, talking about how we are to trust the Lord who knows us, who knows our lives, who knows everything about us. So I invite you to open your hearts and hear the word of the Lord. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light around me become night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Someone from the family is speaking today, I believe, on behalf of David and his life.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Jude Osteido. Permettez-moi de parler français puisque mon anglais n'est pas aussi parfait que ça. Enfin, d'ailleurs, il n'est rien du tout mon anglais. Alors, je prends la parole au nom de la famille aujourd'hui pour vous parler brièvement de King David. On en a parlé hier lors de la veillée, juste un petit rappel de sa vie parmi nous. David est venu dans une famille, est né dans une famille pieuse. Pieuse veut dire pas parfaite, mais une famille qui croit en Dieu, qui croit en Jésus-Christ. Une famille qui a voué sa vie à rendre gloire à Dieu. Et je ne parlerai pas de, si je ne parle pas de l'origine de cette foi, ce serait vraiment un défaut. Alors cette foi leur vient de notre mère, Mamie Akofala Gruniski. La rencontre avec Akofala Gruniski a été une chance, et cela grâce à la maladie d'une des filles de la famille. Et lorsqu'ils ont fait la connaissance d'Akofala, la fille a été sauvée. Et depuis, la famille vit dans une parfaite harmonie avec Dieu. David est donc né de cette famille et a suivi les enseignements bibliques, ce qui fait sa foi. Je vous l'ai dit hier, il s'appelle l'Olonvi, ce qui veut dire l'enfant de l'amour. Et comme vous le savez tous, David a montré cet amour dans sa vie. Toutes les personnes qui ont rencontré David peuvent lui reprocher plein de choses, mais jamais qu'il n'aime pas les gens. David aimait tout le monde. Et comme l'ont dit les témoignages hier, sa générosité dépasse toutes les bornes. Aujourd'hui, nous sommes là. Il nous rassemble encore une fois devant sa dépouille. Nous sommes là pour lui dire au revoir. Nous sommes là pour rendre hommage à David et remercier Dieu pour sa vie parmi nous. Il a vécu pleinement comme Dieu lui a offert de le faire. Et nous sommes fiers de dire aujourd'hui que David est notre frère, David est notre ami, David est notre papa, David est notre oncle. Oui, je dis « est » parce que nous savons que David n'est pas mort. Tous ceux qui croient en Dieu savent qu'en fait que la mort n'est qu'un passage. Nous sommes tous sur cette terre des voyageurs. Le voyage de David est parti dans un autre monde, le monde de Dieu. Alors, rendons grâce à Dieu pour sa vie. J'en profite aussi pour remercier tout un chacun de vous pour votre geste, votre sourire, votre compassion, votre aide, aussi bien matérielle que spirituelle. Que Dieu vous bénisse. Un grand merci de la part de la famille. Soyons tous unis en union de prière pour que l'âme de notre cher frère repose en paix auprès de notre Seigneur. Je vous remercie.
For our New Testament, I am going to read from two passages that are very familiar in our times of grief when we come together to remember someone we love who's gone to be with the Lord. The first passage is from Romans, and I will be reading from Romans 14, 7 through 9. Hear the word of the Lord. This is Paul writing. We do not live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the living and the dead. And the second passage is from the Gospel of John. And I always like to introduce this passage so that we can understand it a little more fully. Let me explain what is happening. Jesus is about to go to the cross. He is going to die. He told his family, his disciples, that was his family, that he was going to die, but they did not understand this. It made no sense to them. The Messiah was not supposed to die. And they are afraid. They are frightened. They're in an upper room and they're locked in, because they're so afraid of what, not just what's going to happen to their teacher and their master, but what's going to happen to them. They're afraid for their own lives. They, like us, do not want to die. And then Jesus comes and sits with them. And as always, Jesus knew what they were feeling. He understood. And this is what he said. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I'm going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. This is the word of the Lord. Amen. I just want to share a few thoughts about David and about his death and his resurrection and about ourselves. Last night, I was privileged to hear so much about David's life from people who came up here and spoke about him with love and with affection. And at the same time, asking you and to forgive him if he did anything wrong. Well, forgiving someone is nice, but Christ had already forgiven him. And he received that grace from the cross, as we all do, all of us. I also was thinking about David and his family, David Alley's family. I think David had many families. First, it was the family of his birthplace and the family of his children and brothers and sisters and parents, his family by relatives, by relations. That's his family, those who are here today. But when I heard that last night, people from all over the world, who I'm sure are watching now, watched our wake, watched the celebration that we shared last night, I realized that David was a part of another family. It was the family of the people he loved and cared for, and the people who loved and cared for him. That is a family also. And let me tell you, they are grieving as well. Just as this family grieves, you grieve, and his family all over the world grieves. And that's what death does to us. He was a father of many, not just of many children, but the father in spirit of many who received his graciousness and his gratitude. I got to experience that as well. And as I mentioned last night, I loved seeing him always on Sunday morning, and he was there on Sunday morning. And it meant a lot to me to see him there. But he was also a son in a family, a child in a family. And that is God's family. That is the family that was made by the blood of Jesus Christ. That is the family that is formed and made through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And we are the family that is gathered here today, to celebrate his life. Sometimes it's good to remind ourselves that services of remembrance that we share, like this one, is really for ourselves and not for him. Whatever anyone may say or remember about the life of David Sumbe Ali, it is a life that has been lived to its completion. And it was a life that he lived as best as he could. Funeral services and memorial services often find ways to praise the best qualities of those in our families and in other places where our lives intersect with each other, such as the community and the church. And there, as I've said, is much for us to praise and hold dear about David's generous and fruitful life. But in Christianity, we focus not upon the goodness inside of us, but the goodness of God. It is a transformative goodness that is able to accept the best of us and the worst of us through divine grace and love. No wonder for so many eons we found no hope in our humanity as we reached out to God, to the eternal, in every way but the right one. But then, what happened? God reached out to us by taking on our humanity through the person of Jesus Christ, and it is in Christ we saw the possibilities that human beings never had before that one life lived and died and lived again. One life lived and died and lived again. It was the possibility of the kind of life that seeks something besides its own purpose. A life whose values are centered on God and not the world. It is a life lived not because of our best qualities, and David had many wonderful qualities, but it is a life lived in spite of our worst qualities. Because each new day, Jesus offers us the ability to start our lives again, to build upon our successes, as David did, he had many, and gain wisdom from our failures, as David also did. I did not know him as well as this family or friends who are gathered to honor him. Though I came to know him in the all too brief time of our friendship. Each of us, all of you, knew David or the members of the family in different ways and in different situations. But God knew David as he truly is and always will be, because God made him. God placed him upon this earth. And Christ knew David because Christ died for him. And this morning, that's all we really need to know. No matter how we strive and agonize to transform ourselves as Christians, God finishes that work when our lives are over. We cannot finish it, but God does. And what great hope that gives us this day as we place our beloved brother and friend, our member of many families, into Christ's eternal care. To David's family here, I say this: God always walks beside you, and God always loves you, just as God loved David. So, walk boldly without fear as you live your lives in the only family that lasts and the only family that matters, the family of God, where we are all made children where we are all made whole, and where we are all brought home to the love and the peace of Christ when our time on earth is over. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. May God bless you and keep you, David's family, friends, this community of faith, and may God bless and keep us in love and discipleship today, now, and in the life to come. David has gone home. He is at peace. And one day, we will be at peace as well. Amen. Our song, our hymn, are two verses of number 625, How Great Thou Art. Please stand. You may be seated. I'm going to say a prayer of thanksgiving for David's life and for your lives, for being here to honor him. But I invite you to put into your mind something about David for which you are thankful. What brought you here to honor him, wherever you are, here or watching us today, that you've put something in your mind for which you are thankful for his life. I'm remembering his friendship. I'm remembering his participation in our worship. That's what I'm thankful for, and that's what I'm thinking about as I say this prayer. And I invite you to do the same. And after I finish the prayer, I will go into the Lord's Prayer, which it is our tradition that we say the Lord's Prayer together, Our Father who art in heaven. But I want to invite you to say it in your own language, whatever language you wish, French or Ewe or whatever language you feel comfortable saying it in, because God hears the prayers, everyone's prayers. So we will conclude after my prayer of thanksgiving. You will hear me say, as the Lord taught us to pray. And then we will do our Lord's Prayer. So let us bow our heads and pray a prayer of thanksgiving. Holy Lord, each of us holds in our hearts and minds at this time a memory of thanksgiving and gratitude for the life of David Sumbe Ali. We are so grateful that in this hour we can gather and remember him. We are so grateful for the memories that are in our minds and in our hearts this day. We are so grateful, Lord, for the force of his life, for his laughter, for his friendship, for his great, great generosity, for the love that he shared with his family. We are thankful, Lord, for the many places and the many lives that he touched wherever he went. And we are thankful, Lord, for his faith in you. And it is out of that faith, Lord, that we can say a prayer of thanksgiving for his forgiveness, even as we are forgiven. And so, Lord, we come as a thankful people. And we are thankful for the promise that you gave at the table when you told your family to do not be afraid, to believe. And so that is what we come to do, to believe and to know that David is with you. We are thankful that we have a home in the eternal, a home in heaven, a home made by your hands for each of us. And until that day comes, Lord, when you call us as you call David, we are thankful that we can live for you and work for you and serve you with love, understanding, patience, compassion, and forgiveness. So thank you for the lessons that he taught. Thank you for the wisdom that he showed. And I thank you, Lord, for this loving family and friends and all those who are gathered to honor him this day. Keep us all, Lord, in your loving care. And help us, Lord, to live our lives with thanksgiving to you each day. All these things, Lord, we pray through the prayer that you taught us to pray that we share together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Before I do the benediction, I want to share with you what we're going to do. I'm going to do the benediction, then I will come down. And then the escorts will come and they will take the casket out of the sanctuary, and then the family will follow. And then you are welcome to come as well, to come out after the family. And then the funeral director will help us get into the processional so that we can conclude our service at the graveside. Again, thank you for coming to honor his life this day, and may the peace and grace of the Lord be with you. And now go forth in the grace, mercy, and peace of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And may the Lord be with us each, both now and forevermore. Amen. Would you please stand?